Hey guys, myself Nitin Awasthi, and you are watching our YouTube channel Abhivyakti Veterinary Research Center. Our today topic is neurophysiology, and neurology is a very interesting topic in both subject, veterinary anatomy and physiology. So without wasting our time, let's start the video. We all know that neurology is most important and interesting topic in both subject veterinary physiology and veterinary anatomy. So let's start. Nervous system. Nervous system is a system that receives the information with regard to changes in the environment. Which environment? Environment may be external and may be internal of the body, and in response regulates appropriate function also. Alright. Then neuron. What is a neuron? Neuron is a major functional unit of the nervous system. Then a neuron is the cell type whose shape can vary considerably with its location and its specific role in the nervous system. Then after that we discuss about the structure of neuron. We all know about that many of the dendrites are visible there, and single one axon are visible there. After that, neuron components. Information receiving area called as dendrites. We all know that dendrites are many in the number, and this is the information receiving area. Alright, then cell body. What is the cell body? We can say it as soma also. And then axon. Axon is an information carrying extension. Alright, then synaptic nerve. What is the synaptic nerve? We can say it this is a presynaptic terminal. Alright, we can say this is the presynaptic terminal in respective synapse. Alright, we know that there are a presynaptic terminal and a postsynaptic terminal. Then this is the presynaptic terminal of synaptic nerve. Axon is often covered with a punctual fatty coating called the myelin sheath that enhance the speed of information transfer along the axon's length. We know that a myelin sheath covering are present there on the axon, and it is enhance the speed of information transfer along the axon length. After that, neurons do not exist in isolation. Always remember that neurons do not exist in isolation. They are usually interconnected within neural circuits or pathway that serve a specific function. Alright, then neuron circuits pathway that are related in function are often collectively referred as neural system. For the example, the reticotactile pathway provide information for reflex orientation of the eyes to the position of a light source. And after that we are discussed that whereas the retino-hypothalamic pathway carries information affecting the body's physiological rhythm is in response to light dark cycle, these individual neural pathways are both part of the visual system. Then neuroglial cell. We are known that in nervous system there are two type of cell are generally found. In the series, first is a neuron and second one is neuroglial cell. The other type cell in the nervous system is the glial cell. We are know that glial cell is also important for nervous system. These cells are important in maintaining the structure and functional integrity of neurons. Glial cells play important roles in the producing the myelin sheath of axons, modulating the growth of developing or damaged neurons. After that, glial cells are formation of contacts between neurons, and they participate in certain immune response of the nervous system. Glial cells do not produce action potential, but growing evidence indicates that they can indirectly monitor the electrical activity of neurons. Alright, then this is the structure of general structure of astrocytes. We all know about it, but after sometime we also discuss it in our next video. So this is the whole about today video, and this is an introductory video to neurology. After that we are discuss about next level of neurology. So please don't forget to watch next videos of ours, and please subscribe our channel.